is the currently fastest AMD Navy architecture RDNA-powered graphics card, the Radeon RX 5700 XT, finally supported in macOS? Can you use it in your Hackintosh build or with a Mac? Is this finally the best price-to-performance ratio GPU for your Hackintosh? Let's find out! Hi, I'm Teresa from morgonau.cloud and I help people with Apple computers, Hackintosh builds, Linux servers, simply overall with computers. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. 14 days ago, I informed on my channel and sites that Apple finally brought some partial support for the AMD Navy Architecture RDNA graphics cards in the macOS Catalina 10.15.1 beta release. Then went through internet some rumors. Apple removed this support. Few days ago, Apple released the final macOS Catalina 10.15.1 version. So, most people are interested if the 5700 series GPUs from AMD are finally supported. So, the answer is yes, they are. You can start to celebrate. This video is not a review, I just wanted to let you know my personal experience and share with you these positive good news. So, let's move to the actual build. This is one of my so-called 14-core iMac Pro killer Hackintosh builds. If you missed my video series about this monster Hackintosh, links to it you can find now in this video description. So, let's have a look on the screen. Here, as a proof, you can see I'm running the AMD Radeon RX 5700 XT inside of latest macOS Catalina 10.15.1 on my Intel i9-9900K Hackintosh build. AMD Radeon RX 5700 XT, latest Metal version fully supported. So, let's shortly test it in DaVinci Resolve Studio 16. As you can see, the AMD Radeon RX 5700 XT automatically picked up by Resolve using Metal. As always, 4K timeline with ProRes 4K 422 10-bit source footage. Timeline scrubbing is absolutely fantastic. So, let's quickly try H.264 export renderer using hardware acceleration, 4K resolution, 30 FPS, and let's see if the 5700 XT will be fully utilized. As expected, maxed out 5700 XT. Render is even faster than real-time in 4K resolution on this GPU. So, in DaVinci Resolve, the AMD Radeon RX 5700 XT is working really great on my Hackintosh build. And for nitpickers, if it's working great in DaVinci Resolve, there's no need for me to show it also in Final Cut, Premiere, or any other application, when the system recognizes it and it's fully utilized. By the way, why would someone want to use that Adobe crap? Why not to use the best tool simply? So, Metal is working great. Now just shortly put this AMD 5700 XT under heavy load in 3D rendering using the Luxmark benchmark to see if also OpenCL workloads can this 5700 XT handle as good as Metal ones. Luxball scene score is 27,844. Hotel scene score 5,157. And Neumann scene 21,177. If you want to compare results on this same hardware with my AMD Vega Frontier Edition, then watch my huge comparison AMD versus Intel Hackintosh benchmark comparison video. Link is in video description. I chose and tested the reference Sapphire Radeon RX 5700 XT and now I can hear those haters. Why did you choose this one instead of some 2 or 3 fans custom model? Answer is easy. Those who will choose this reference model can at any time later easily add to this card custom water cooling from big brands like EK. Custom models with non-reference PCB can't. And another reason why I like these reference models with the blower style fan is better temperature conditions inside of computer case. Because it's sucking air from the case and exhausts the hot air straight away from the computer. So temperature inside of the case will be always lower than with those two or three fans models. And that's good for lifespan and performance of all of your components. And because I always strictly recommend only components I personally tested and verified, I can recommend exactly this model and can't judge any other models. So in this video description you can find links where you can buy directly this exact 5700 XT I tested. By the way, you absolutely don't have to fear about overheating this GPU or insane noise. The fan during video rendering was noticeable, but not annoying, nothing extreme. It's rendering, full GPU utilization. I think now you can hear the GPU fan. Yes. I had also my case side panel open and my computer was next to my head on the table for purpose of this video. So under my table with closed case it's really barely noticeable. Also don't forget, these drivers which Apple included in the macOS Catalina 10.15.1 are just first version of drivers. I have no doubt Apple will even more improve it over time. The performance is quite as good as Vega 64, but with lower power consumption. So, can I recommend to buy this AMD Radeon RX 5700 XT for your Hackintosh build or to real Mac users? Well, it's a good GPU, and I will put it into even more depth testing. But the simple fact it needs macOS Catalina 10.15.1 to run it holds me back from recommending it to everybody. There is still a lot of people who needs macOS Mojave or older system for their work. Also, macOS Catalina is still in early stage. So if you want to experiment and use macOS Catalina instead of macOS Mojave on your Hackintosh or Apple Mac, then this 5700 XT GPU will be probably good choice for you. If you will have some further questions, feel free to comment down below. And by the way, if you would need some help with Apple Mac, Linux, Windows computer, BSD, server for virtualization, ZFS file server, video editing, fine-tuning your workflow or just consulting, you can always get my personal individual support on my Patreon or Subscribestar. Links are again in this video description. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button and share this video with your friends so it can help to more people. Don't forget to subscribe to both of my YouTube channels and hit the bell next to it so you will get notifications about my new videos. You can also visit my Facebook, Twitter, Reddit or my website. Morgonaut is always here to help. And of course don't forget to watch my other videos. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time my Hackintosh friends.